name's Lizzie and I'm a PhD student at the University of Oxford. Today I'm going to be giving you a sneak peek behind the scenes into life as a scientist in the lab. So follow me. It's really noisy in the lab, so I'm going to have a quick chat to you here first. For my research, I spend a lot of time working with cells. But what's a cell? So our bodies are made up of organs, such as the lung and the heart, and these organs are made up of tissues, which in turn are made up of cells. In fact, there's over 37 trillion cells in your body, and that's more than the number of stars in the galaxy. As scientists, we work with cells to help answer important questions about our bodies without having to use patients. Cells can come directly from an animal or a patient into the lab, and these are called primary cells. However, the easiest type of cell to work with, and therefore the most common, are cancer cells. It might seem strange to use cancer cells, but it's because they're immortal that we use them. They keep on dividing forever. In the lab, we use cells to look at responses to certain stimuli, such as to viral infection or to certain drugs. We can also genetically alter cells to have more of something or be deficient in something else, and this can help us to understand the various functions of different hormones and proteins in the cell. Because cells aren't a whole being, or even a whole organ, we can't say with absolute certainty that what we see happening in cells translates to what happens in real life. However, now scientists are developing organoids, which are mini organs grown in a lab, and these are much more of a mimic of reality. We're getting closer and closer to great model systems in medical science, and the new developments in the field are very exciting. Let me show you how we split cells in the lab. We need to do this because cells divide every day, and soon there is no more physical space for any new cells in the dish, and they've absorbed all the nutrients. Every 3 days or so we split them, which involves removing half of the cells and adding more food. Most cell lines are sticky, and they stick to the dish. Therefore, we first need to unstick them before we can halve them. First, we take the food off of the cells and we wash the cells to get the remnants of the food away. We then put on a reagent to unstick the cells. Once they've come off the dish, we collect them all into a tube and spin them incredibly fast at 1,500 rotations a minute. This causes all the cells to form a solid pellet at the bottom of the tube, which you can see visually. We then put more food on the pellet and put half of that pellet into a new dish with new food. When we go on holiday, we often ask someone to look after our cells for us, as they can't be left for too long.
Thank you for joining me in the lab today, and if you have any questions, please pop them in the comments.